Welcome. You are now invited to join
the conclave of the West.
Hello and welcome back to the show. I'm Al, this is Joe.
Hi.
And that's Chris.
Hiya.
We're going to do some questions because we get so many off you that we're just going to
mix it up and
just do a questions episode again.
Q&A session.
Black tie of... Oh, sorry, I'm just reading that one. I'm texting.
What are you texting?
Sorry. I was typing black tie and just said it.
You're texting Laura trying to see if you can get out this black tie thing.
A little bit.
If you do, fancy a few drinks tonight? We'll go to Kong.
I can't go to town.
Oh, for sure.
Right, so we got the... can we get some questions? Owen's going to read them out and we're going to answer them.
Oh, yeah. Ready then?
No.
Nah.
Okay. what would the name of your debut album be?
Oh. What kind of album is it?
Your album.
Oh.
Mine would be jazz.
just jazz. Yeah, mine would be something arty. It would just be like self-titled.
Yeah, nice.
Or just like, yeah. It would just be a black case.
The Al Jones Show.
Yeah. we should call this that, maybe.
Yeah.
Al and Friends.
Al and Friends. Yeah.
The Alex Jones Experience.
Oh, yeah, Alex Jones and the Common Clay of the New West.
Yeah, no. The band. My debut album would be called Music by Joe.
Oh, nice, yeah. Chris?
The Fidgets and Widgets.
Oh.
Okay.
Chris Hutchins Experience.
Oh, nice.
Two.
Nice. Yeah, come in with your debut album as a sequel. Yeah.
Greatest hits.
Greatest hits. To be fair, it would be. Your debut album would be your greatest hit. Yeah. Well, at least your
greatest hits up until that point, anyway.
Yeah. I'd do Metallica Black Album. That's what it'd be called. I don't even think that's what it was called. That was just always referred to.
I think that's what mine would be, just black cover.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Just like,
yeah.
What is it?
Oh.
Yeah. Smell. Straight out of Philly.
Smell the glove. Good question.
Yeah. Never mind.
Oh.
That wasn't their debut album, though. But it was an album.
Yeah, but it would be mine, though.
Oh.
Bleach. That was your first one, wasn't it?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah. Sorry, next question.
Next question.
Please.
Do you have any advice for your previous boss?
My previous boss.
Yeah, pay me more money.
Yeah, stock off and die.
Oh! I was going to say, stop wearing a gilet, you look like a wanker.
I want to know more about Chris's.
Yeah, I also
want to know more about yours.
He used to wear a gilet and he looked like a wanker.
Nailed it.
So there you go, Chris.
To be fair, it's hard to wear a gilet and not look like a wanker.
Yeah, yeah.
But if you're the boss, you've got to... He probably was like, I don't want to wear the gilet, but I have to distance myself. I don't want them being too friendly with me. So I got to alienate myself by looking like a wanker.
Maybe, yeah.
Or he was a wanker. Yeah. And why do you wish death upon yours?
I just didn't like him much. I went through a period of having no boss, which was brilliant, and then I had a boss, and he didn't like me. His name was David, and he was French, and I used to call him Die French in front of everyone. And he'd be like, Chris, this is not that. Well, he's not French. This is not my name. And I'd be like, oh, Die, calm down, bud. And he did loads of disciplinaries on me and that, and then, we just didn't get on. Fuck you, Die French.
Yeah. Oh. Well, fuck you, Die French.
Mm. Yeah, mine would be don't fire me the way I wasn't fired. That's not for the show. Not to be discussed on air.
Mine would be just stop it. Stop wearing the gilet and just stop it.
It might be just pay me more money or let me be the boss for a day. That's what they should do. Not Dressed Down Friday, be like Random Boss Friday.
Yeah, how's that? That was my issue, was that my old job, I was very unsupervised 9 days out of 10. And then...
10 days a week.
Sometimes. Yeah. 4 out of 5 then. And then sometimes he'd just be there And he'd be like, you don't do anything, do some stuff. I'm like, take your fucking Geely off, it's inside. And he'd be like, do something. I'd be like, I'm sitting.
It's the most pointless item of clothing as well.
Yeah.
I mean,
are you cold or are you not?
Exactly.
Yeah. It's like a tie. What's the point in a tie?
Oh, I knew that. I know the answer.
It used
can't
to be
remember.
To keep your shirt done up. They didn't have buttons all the way up or something.
Yeah.
So the buttons would stop at your like chest. So then you'd put a tie to keep it tied
one,
up to the top.
One day some guy went, I'll tell you what we should do. buttons all the way to the top.
Well, fuck, I forgot my tie. I'll give me a couple more of them buttons. Come on. I like wearing a tie.
I enjoy wearing a tie.
Getting fancy.
Yeah. And it helps that I can tie a tie because I had to do it for school. And like, I'm surprised how many people our age can't do it.
Really?
Yeah.
So what people are you hanging out with?
Well, I don't remember, like, people, like, when they find... Well, people are more shocked when they find out, you can tie a tie.
Yeah, that is quite
shocking. Well. And I can just do it really...
Quite well.
I don't...
I'm quite shocked you can tie a tie.
Some people don't even... Like, they have to look, and they unfollow it, or I can just bang one out, and just like, there you go.
Banging out them ties.
So ties.
Ties.
What was the question?
Oh, do you know what I was doing in the pub last night? I kept taking my shoe off because I don't know why, because I was drunk. And then I was sort of dancing around with one shoe on, one shoe off, like hopping around because I didn't want to put my sock on the floor of the pub. And then everyone was taking my shoes off.
I know.
And then people kept taking my shoes and throwing them away and I had to get it. Oh, it was a whole thing. I just had a little flashback.
Sounds like you brought it on yourself.
I didn't very much. And then I kept complaining and then someone said that to me and I was like, I'm fucking... And then I flicked my shoe off.
My girlfriend does that around the flat to me. She wears slippers around the flat and she'll just... I'll say something and she'll just fling her fucking slipper at the back of my head.
Like a quick pistol draw. Fucking shoes
she's
around.
Getting pretty accurate with it as well.
I've noticed that bruise on your head. She's beating you again. Do you want to talk? We'll talk about it off air.
Yeah. Off air, please.
Can we get some tissues for Chris, please? Yeah. He's crying again.
And another question. We better move on. Otherwise, Chris is going to.
Okay. I've got one. Got one here from Joe's housemate, Rob, that says, would you rather eat chocolate pudding that tastes like shit or shit that tastes like chocolate pudding?
Is the shit still shit? Like, am I going to get ill? Because, you know, if you ate shit, you'd just be ill.
Yeah, you probably would be ill.
But, like, just because it tastes like chocolate pudding, is it going to stop me being ill? That'd be my biggest concern. Mm. Like, I'd rather have 2 minutes of, oh, I was disgusting, rather than a week of going, oh, I'm really ill because I ate shit.
Do you hear about the guy in Australia that, for, like, a sort of a dare, or there's loads of, like, guys hanging out drinking beer, he ate, like, a slug or something on the floor, and he's just paralysed for life now. It's not funny.
Really?
What are you laughing for? Yeah, it was really sad. Like he's now like literally paralyzed from like the neck down. Yeah, don't eat slugs and stuff on the floor.
Yeah,
especially in Australia. Like, don't touch anything in Australia, and you still might die.
Yeah.
I'd never go to Australia. It just terrifies me. Everything's scary.
Yeah, I have been to Australia. Didn't die.
When I first got a puppy, they were like, the vet was like, don't let him near slugs because puppies will eat slugs and they get a lungworm and they just have coughs for the rest of their life. Then.
So, really? I didn't know that.
That's
good advice for everyone that's
getting dogs. Yeah. And now he can be around slugs and not try and eat them now, but when he's a puppy, they just...
They don't know better.
No.
What's the difference between slugs and snails, then? Because you can eat snails in France. How do you not get the same thing? Because it's just a slug with a house.
They probably breed them not crawling around on the floor with all worms. They probably keep them in like jars in labs.
It's the same as don't eat a fish out of Caerphilly Castle moat, but you buy a fish from Asda's.
Yeah. I don't know, are slugs just snails with a shell? I don't think so.
I think they are different.
With a house, sorry.
Yeah, they're like middle class slugs.
homeless
slugs.
Snails.
Slugs are just homeless snails.
Yeah. I feel bad now. Definitely don't eat them, they're already on hard times. So to answer your question, probably shit flavoured chocolate pudding. What was the question again?
I
want to taste chocolate pudding. I'd eat the shit. It looks like shit, but tastes like chocolate pudding, probably.
Does it look like shit, but it's actually chocolate pudding? Or is it actually shit?
Oh, just the flavour.
Do you mean, am I going to have parasites in my stomach and that? Because I've eaten probably. Shit. I'll take the chocolate pudding that tastes like shit.
You want to eat shit? No, you don't want to eat shit.
Yeah, I know. It's weird.
Complicated question.
The next question is going to be, what's the difference between slugs and snails?
How do you stop your dogs getting lungworm? Covered it next.
Yeah, the first one, I think. Well, we could do a vote. I'd say the first one, just to get it over with. And
yeah,
just...
same, I agree.
Yeah, first one.
Yeah.
The first one was... Which way around was it?
The first one, I'd rather eat the shit that tasted like...
I'd rather eat the chocolate.
I'd rather that one.
It's the most passionately we've ever discussed anything.
All right, next one. What is the most ridiculous thing to fill a piñata with?
Shit flavored chocolate pudding.
More piñatas.
Never ending piñata. Yeah.
Well,
I said body parts. Body parts. Yours was far less dark.
Yeah, my mind instantly went to like razor blades and new syringes and stuff. But
AIDS.
AIDS. Why sauce? Just something like AIDS hit, it just pops everywhere. Yeah. Makes a mess.
Battery acid.
Yeah, tar.
But I do like more piñata. Like a Russian doll effect. There's always one more. I've seen those videos of those piñatas. They look really tough. They look really well made.
I've done one once.
Did you get through it?
Yeah, of course I did.
Smashed it.
Like, I knocked it down. So it came off the thing, and then we just kind of like
mobbed
it on the floor. Yeah,
mobbed it.
Till the sweets came out.
I think I've seen some videos where they kind of have it on like a pulley system.
Yeah.
So when the kid goes to hit it, they pull it up.
Yeah.
And that looks like never ending fun. I mean, I could do that for days.
Well, you meant to be blindfolded as well, I think. I wasn't. I just had a baseball bat. Yeah. It was just there.
I took a hacksaw to it.
Get those fucking sweets.
What were you doing in a piñata? What
I can't
Mexican
remember why.
Kids. Quinceañera, were you at?
That was a dream joke. My go.
Yeah. My go.
Stomped it.
Spear tackled it. Your signature move.
Yeah. It is the coolest wrestling move.
Oh, the gore.
Well. Yeah.
Who was it that did the gore?
Rhino.
Rhino,
but
yeah.
Edge also did. Edge was more of like a spear.
Right. Rhino did the gore off the ropes.
It was more of like a proper takedown one.
Yeah. Because I remember one of the WrestleMania WWE games that always went Rhino the gore. He was by far like a mediocre wrestler on that game, but the gore was so powerful.
Yeah.
Just goring people.
Yeah. So spear?
Spears. Oh no, I'll tell you what not to put in there. Rhino. He'd bust out and gore everyone.
Yeah.
Rhino.
Rhino the wrestler. From 2004.
Him. Tag team with Takeshi.
Rikishi.
No.
Famously went on to have a castle.
Spin off. Do you mean Rikishi?
No, the little guy who used to spit the green stuff.
Oh, I don't know.
It was the guy that done the stinky face.
That's Rikishi,
yeah.
That was Rikishi.
Stink face.
Stink face. Terrible. Terrible move.
Next question.
Okay. I've got one here from somebody called Tash.
Oh, hey, Tash.
I don't know who she is or where she's from.
I think he does.
Your house.
She says, what words really grate on you? For example, mine are hun, cool beans, and FOMO.
Oh, I've got good. Yeah, I know this one.
Go on.
Anyone that refers to their partner as this one.
This one.
I fucking hate that.
And I do it to Joe all the time.
Anyone that calls holidays hollybobs.
Hollybobs,
yeah, I'm not a
fan of
that.
Yeah, I'm not a fan of that either. We've been to the Game Changer was my one that we did before. Yeah, I did really didn't like that one. But awesome sauce.
What was the question? Words you don't like or do like?
Tech. Words that grate on you.
Don't. Ones that grate on you.
Oh, ones that grate on you. I like cool beans. I say cool beans all the time. It's from a hot rod, isn't it?
Yeah.
Is it a hot rod?
I don't like it.
It's because you're not cool beans.
Yeah, that's true.
Hollybobs is the worst.
Hollybobs is just awful.
Fry-yay.
Oh, yeah, that can fuck off.
Loads. Anything that's like popular on the internet, basically.
Yeah, well, yeah, popular with weirdos.
Totes. Totes. I don't mind totes.
You know what was funny? We were talking the other day that, you know, the abbreviation, obviously, for World Wide Web, WWW, there's more syllables in saying WWW than there is World Wide Web.
That's
like by a considerably large amount, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, there we go. Nice. Yeah.
Whoa.
Fixed it.
Yeah. Fixed it immediately. Look at this. When was the last time you put in www.
I know.
Dot?
I remember when I used to first got a computer and I had like a book of links and websites and stuff. And I put like the HTTPS.
Book?
Yeah, it was my first computer. It came with like a book of just like websites.
Websites you might want to visit.
Yeah, yeah. And it was like, I was like, okay, /https://rotten.com.
Pornhub.
Amazeballs, Game Changer.
Holly Bobs.
I quite like all of these. Am I the bad person?
There's loads.
We're keeping Cool Beans, though.
Yeah, we're keeping Cool Beans, I think.
Yeah.
Cool Beans?
Cool Beans.
It's Cool Beans.
Move on.
Cool Beans. What is something you really want your parents to say to you?
That they love me and they're proud of me. Maybe one day.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm going to hold my breath, though.
Here's a pinata full of pinata.
Bees.
Yeah. Bees. Yeah, bees.
No, bees would have been a good one.
Yeah, bees.
Yeah. Bees.
Bees. Bees.
I'd love them to say, Joe, we won the lottery. We got 50 mil. Here's a couple of mil. Quit your job and go travel the world. Or invest it in your podcast.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'd like them to say to me, I know how to use my iPhone. You don't need to help me.
every two weeks, every time there's a new update. Yeah. It turned out it's very sort of user-friendly technology, and we've mastered it.
Yep.
What would you do with your Sunday afternoons then?
Yeah, what's I'm doing tomorrow? I'm going to see my granddad to show him how to use his sat-nav on his new car.
Brilliant.
To be fair, you had to do that to me the other day, teach me how to use the film in the screen thing.
Yeah,
that I was convinced I didn't have.
I love that feature.
It is a good feature. We've been through that, though.
We have talked about that.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, is there going to be a point on the podcast where like we've talked about everything in the world?
Like,
to be fair, Joe Rogan's still going.
Yeah, he does like 4-hour ones.
Yeah,
like, what should we talk about today? Like MMA?
M&M.
We'll just talk about Joe Rogan's. We'll do a... I was talking to Rob, my housemate, the other day about doing a spin-off podcast. You know, like they do The Walking Dead, they do a show called The Talking Dead.
Yeah.
Where they talk about they'll do a Common Clay talking.
Be like Chris Hardwick and two other people going, yeah, look at when he said this.
Really famous people on there. I forgot the question again.
What was the question? It doesn't matter. Oh, what would you like your parents to say to you?
Well,
hello.
Yeah.
Dad.
Yeah.
I'm back.
Anything, Chris?
No, I quite liked your money one.
Yeah, that'd be quite nice, wouldn't
I'd like him to stop borrowing money off me and ask it. Yeah. Get some money of your own, like.
I'd like them to say, Merry Christmas, Joe. Here's a gilet.
Oh, nice. Yeah, yeah.
Next question.
Please. Yeah, go for it.
What will you never try?
Pegging.
My head went exactly the same place. Yeah, not doing that.
There's lots of weird sexual things. I think, well, maybe I would one day. But then when I discovered what that one was, I was like, nah, that's not.
What is it? I'm not sure.
When a woman fucks a guy in the ass with a strap on.
Oh, yeah, no. I'm not.
I know about that, definitely. Oh, no, yeah, I wouldn't try that.
No, that's okay.
When I ran the sex toy website, there's loads of things that I sold that I had to sort of Google to find out what they did. There's lots of, like, medical instruments that people use for sex stuff that go in holes that are not for... You're not meant to put things in those holes. medical instruments up to your...
Yeah, it's like, I gave you a bunch of holes you could put stuff in. Not a bunch that you shouldn't. Yeah, God, I think.
Yeah.
Can I say
you can say whatever you want, mate.
No. I'm making it worse.
Oh, right, I thought you meant, like, because it was rude. Now I've just realised what you meant. Probably not.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's okay.
Yeah, cut that bit out.
Nah.
Urethra.
Just overdub that. Urethra.
Yeah.
Just keep saying it. It's fine.
Things I'd never do or try.
Beans. Baked beans. I have had them in my life.
That's a good point. Have you ever eaten beans?
Yeah.
Baked beans. A mouthful of beans.
Once. It was over a friend's house and then I was like, I don't like them. And the mum was like, yeah, well, you're not leaving the table till you finish your food. Like, what, not
your friend's mum?
Yeah. Like a friend from school's mum. And I was like, oh, and I ate one mouthful, and I was like, I feel really sick, and I was like, I'd rather just go home.
I want to go home now.
Yeah, yeah. Like, my mum doesn't make me.
I get to eat crisps for dinner. I'm going to be a well-rounded adult.
She's like, yes, Alex, that's why you're here.
Yeah. Yeah, social services around your house currently. You can't go home. Yeah, like heroin, I probably wouldn't try. No. I don't think I want any of that in my life.
No.
Try it once. Spice, like, if you're on your deathbed, just try it once.
Well, maybe, actually, yeah.
Be... Spice, that's what I need all day.
Crazy street drug.
Yeah, yeah, not into that.
Yeah. Never say never.
Yeah, just bad things.
Lots of every new, yeah.
Yeah, stuff up your willy-o.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, that's generally for... that's one-way traffic, really, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Cool. Next question.
Oh. Cool beans.
I got a funny story about people putting stuff in their urethras. There's a TV show I watched a few years ago, like, sort of embarrassing or dangerous sex stories. It was on, like, Channel 4 at, like, midnight or something.
Yeah.
And a guy put a... like a little daisy or something down his urethra to surprise his partner.
I've heard this.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And went in fine and then surprised his partner. And they were like, oh, yeah, great. How funny that is. And they were like, pop it out there and let's get at it. Like, as they pulled the daisy or the flower or the plant, whatever, out, there was tiny little hairs that were kind of upward facing. So as you push it downwards, they didn't affect it. But as you pulled it up, they kind of umbrellaed out and shredded all his urethra. So they did
delicate
not. They didn't have fun times that night. Maybe never again. I don't know.
No.
I tell you, just gagged a little bit.
Yeah, looks in pain.
He's red. I'm having flashbacks to googling those things when I bought them. Sex to the website.
Is that why you don't run that company anymore?
Yeah, I couldn't. People are
too much.
People are weird.
Yeah,
got requests for things in there. And I was like, don't think that's legal.
Were people trying to order flowers?
Oh, God.
Never stick a daisy down your cock.
There you go.
It's all about learning.
Yeah. Every day is a school day. Learn from this other guy.
No slugs for your dog. No daisies on your
car. No slugs for yourself either.
No slugs for yourself,
Learn from other people's mistakes.
Snails are slugs with houses.
The takeaway point for this episode.
Groundbreaking podcasting. Next question.
Yeah.
Okay. What is a film that everyone loves that just didn't do it for you?
I thought the question was going to be, what is a film? I was like,
what is a film?
Yeah. What, that everyone loved it, but I didn't,
Anything set in space.
Mm.
I don't think, like, things that can't happen. Apart from talking dogs, I suppose.
I was going to say, so Air Bud. Yeah.
Well, the thing is, he doesn't talk, so it is, like, physically possible.
Well, that a dog could play professional basketball.
Well, yeah, and baseball. And football. Right.
We had a assistant manager dog a couple of weeks back.
Yeah.
True, so. Yeah, dog assistant manager of a football team.
What's Abud doing now? He must have retired.
Just coaching, yeah.
Yeah,
Definitely coaching.
Passing on wisdom.
Or maybe he's doing a Maradona and just partying his way around major football tournaments.
Just doing loads of coke.
I love that guy. He's just unashamedly doing whatever he's doing. He's like, I don't give a fuck. I'm celebrating.
A film I don't like that everyone likes is I Am Legend.
Yeah, it was alright.
Oh, I can't. No, the bit with the dog, I can't.
It's true, yeah, it's a sad bit in that. But again, like, it's just really bad CGI monsters. Not scary.
Yeah, I think there was more to it. It wasn't really a scary film, though, was it?
It looked shit. Like, it just looked awful.
Yeah, and there was a lot of hype about it.
Yeah, yeah. The best thing about it was that it had the first poster for a Batman vs Superman film in the first bit, even like 10 years before it actually came out. There's a bit where Will Smith is driving down there and there's a Batman Superman logo.
I remember that.
And then that's when everyone went, ooh. And then the Avengers went, now better. We're better.
Yeah, yeah. we've nailed it.
Yeah, yeah.
I've got one. Cloverfield.
No, you're wrong.
I'm wrong.
You're wrong. Sorry. You're wrong. It's great.
Yeah,
I've never seen it.
I didn't think it was that great. Don't bother.
No.
It's the perfect film for what it wants to be.
What does it want to be? An average film?
Yeah, I remember you saying this.
I'm not going to get into it. But for what it wants to be, which is a light-hearted monster movie.
Destruction, monster romp.
Monster romp with a bit of comedy. Good CGI. Really good CGI.
Yeah, there's none in there.
Yeah. Oh, no.
It's like the monster. Oh, you get 2 seconds of the monster.
Yeah.
And then some buildings falling down. The buildings falling down look quite good.
Yeah, yeah. And, it's just really good. Really good. Really and very good, viral marketing campaign leading up to it as well.
Yeah, true.
The sequels, not so much. They can fuck off. Yeah. So there you go. So that's why you're wrong there.
So what we've got space films.
Apart
from Space Jam.
Apart from Space Jam, that was good.
Remember Space Jam? I literally can't think of the film Space Jam without thinking that. Guy tweeting Michael Jordan or texting him. Someone's got my phone number, they can text me saying, remember Space Jam. So, films in space, apart from Space Jam. I Am Legend.
And does any films, horror films or like scary films that use over rely on CGI?
Okay.
There you go.
Star Wars.
No, we can't end on that. Star Wars is great.
Star Wars is great. Yeah. You haven't seen it, so you can't really comment
on
it.
True, actually.
I've seen the cartoon version. That was pretty good.
The Clone Wars.
Yeah.
I haven't.
How many? There's loads, isn't it? It's like one of those things where you start it and you think...
Oh, I'm a bit like that with Sopranos. I'm like, oh, if I missed it.
Yeah, but Sopranos could happen, see? Yeah, it's real life. It's based on a true story.
Is it?
No.
Don't know. It's gangsters, isn't it?
Yeah, true.
I like the theme tune.
Definitely happened.
Get yourself a gun. Yeah. That's good. It's good theme tune.
It's probably the best theme tune of any TV show ever.
Peaky Blinders?
Yeah, true. That's probably better, actually.
It's good.
They're on par. They're on par. To be honest, I never get bored of the Game of Thrones intro.
Yeah.
And I'm like, it goes on for ages, but I'm like, I never skip it. It just gets me amped for what's
happening. I'm always just like, sometimes I send a voice note to Chris of just me doing it.
Do you do you watch Game of Thrones?
Lucy watches Game of Thrones, and I'm usually in the room while Game of Thrones is on.
And you love it?
No, I do. It is quite good. I look up when it's tits and that. it is good. It's okay.
Okay. So that's your one then. Well, it's not really a film, but production values same sort of.
Yeah. It is good for what it is. I just don't. Dragons and that.
I'm a bit like that. I was like before Lord of the Rings. I was like, Lord of the fantasy and that.
I've never seen Lord.
Then you watch it. Oh, actually. Really good. Same with Game of Thrones, like dragons and all that. You go, oh, but then when you get into it, you're like, oh, those dragons are badass.
Yeah, can't wait to see more dragons.
Yeah.
Well, one day I'll watch a film like that that's like fantasy or sci-fi or something, and I think, oh, that's a good film, but it's just yet to happen.
Don't watch Reign of Fire.
What's that?
It's a fantasy film that's terrible. With Christian Bale.
Is it?
Yeah. I walked out the cinema.
Really?
It's such shit.
I don't think I've ever done that in cinema.
I did it once for that and for The Bachelor. It was a really shit film. I went to watch something at 15 and I couldn't get in. And then me and Luke were here, let's go watch that film. It's at 12. We went and watched it and it was just us in there and then a load of chavvy people behind us and they were just throwing stuff at us.
Oh,
and I was just like, this film is shit, I'm getting bullied. I'm just leaving.
I've been kicked out of cinema, but...
What for?
That's it. When on my 16th birthday... I went to watch like a late night show and some film in the cinema near us. And my mate, as a surprise for my birthday, I don't know what. Bear in mind, this was before the Batman shootings. My mate, as a surprise for me, halfway through the film, took a can of deodorant and a lighter and just sprayed it into the air. And it was this massive fireball. And everyone in the cinema shit themselves. And for some reason, they asked us to leave.
But it's my birthday.
Yeah. He said happy birthday as he did it. Happy birthday!
You have odd friends.
Yeah.
Was that one of the midnight showings?
Yeah, it was like a really late night showing.
Yeah, I went to Transformers 2 the day it came out.
I was with you.
It was awful. Terrible film. Really long, bad film.
Yeah, and then you leave the cinema at like 3 in the morning, like, oh, I'm really confused. Yeah, and we were drinking as well, weren't we? Yeah, because I went to take about 4 P's.
Yeah, yeah.
Because it was a 3-hour film. I drank 6 cans.
Yeah.
As you do.
Yeah.
Well, the thing is, I think we'd started drinking and then everyone proposed this idea to go watch it. And we're like, yeah, that's a good idea. But then we sort of forgot the reality of actually sitting in a dark room quiet watching a film drunk. So you'd either sober up or you've got to keep going. So we decided to keep going.
Yeah, yeah.
It was odd. Don't do that.
Yeah, I wouldn't do it again. I wouldn't go to a midnight show again. Yeah. Just to watch a film before anyone else.
Like, the day before.
Yeah. Now I just don't go to the cinema and just wait for it to come on Sky. Yeah.
Oh, I like the cinema.
Just wait till someone films it and watch it on the internet. You see those dodgy streams where people are walking to the toilet.
They've died off a little bit, haven't they? You don't see that so much anymore. We've got too many nice things in our houses to deal with shit quality now.
Yeah.
All right, next question.
All right, then, this is the last question, then, fellas. What is your favourite 90s jam?
Teg spicing it
Space
up.
Space Jam.
You spiced up the question a little bit there, Oz. I like that.
Yeah. You're a host. Host.
You making a play for our jobs, yeah? the question? Sorry, I was confused by the
favourite 90s
delivery.
Jam.
Favourite 90s jam.
Oh, I'll tell you what we were talking about.
Marmalade.
Yeah, strawberry.
My favourite jam. Orange marmalade.
I think my lady marmalade. Moulin Rouge song.
Good song.
Summertime. Will Smith and DJ Jazzy
Jeff.
Yeah, you can't go wrong with Will Smith.
Yeah, we were talking about that the other day in the pub. I was like, it's an absolute tune.
Yeah, anything by Sublime as well.
Yeah, true.
They did lots of good summer songs, didn't they, in the 90s?
Yeah.
Smash Mouth, the 90s? That was like early 2000s.
Mm, it was Shrek 1, so no, probably early 2000s.
Was there not a song before that, though?
Some.
It was Body. It was definitely... it was definitely the official song for that. I don't know if it probably was a song before, but I don't know. It was probably new when that came out.
21 Seconds. No, that's 2000s as well. Right?
Yeah, just, I'd say. Yeah, well, that's about 2001.
I know for a fact it was, because when I was in secondary school, in comprehensive school, someone from NatWest came into the school.
Yeah.
And to recruit kids to sign up to their current account or something. They gave you 21 Seconds So Solid Crew CD. And I was like, obviously I'm signing up. That's, that's still my current bank account.
It's still my bank account. Yeah.
They got me for life.
Yeah.
I've had loans, credit cards, everything. Student loans and student overdrafts with them.
It's because when you have to, like, you're applying for something, you say, they say, oh, when did you start your bank account? I always know that was September 2001.
There you go.
It was year 8. First couple of days of year 8 it was.
Yeah. So there was everyone just pumping So Solid Crew for about 6 months.
Yeah.
Was there anyone in your school that was savvy to bank accounts and were looking at the interest rates and decided not to go in NatWest that day?
CDs.
Yeah, it was so much so that a few years ago I was in the bank doing something and they were like, oh yeah, we'll see your ID and this, that and the other. And they were like, oh, your name's Joseph. I was like, yep. They're like, but your account says Joe. I was like, yep, same person, same thing. They were like, oh, we're quite a bit of a stickler for detail in the bank. And I was like, well, just whatever then. And they were like, well, why did you say Joe? I was like, you signed me up when I was 11 years old. What do you think I was going to... Yeah, I didn't think I was going to have this forever. So I had to go at them, flipped it.
Yeah, I do that. Obviously, my name's Alexander, but I go by Al or Alex. So
you signed up saying Beansy. Beansy, bye.
I didn't know you were Alexander.
I am Alexander.
Wait, has Ollie got a longer name?
Oliver.
Fucking hell.
Yeah. Is Luke, what, like Luke? Lucas? Is he?
Lucathan.
No, Luke's just Lucathan.
Lucathy, yeah.
Summertime. Will Smith. Summertime. Can we play out with Summertime by Will Smith, please? And DJ Jazzy Jeff.
I go with that.
I can't think what it goes like.
Summertime.
Miami.
Yeah, summertime.
No, that was Miami. Because I know for a fact it was the 90s, because I think it was...
It was.
I know for a fact because I think. I think it was on his
was
Millennium album. Well, maybe it was even before that. And that
it
came
was
out
before
in
that. Millennium was more recent, definitely. Yeah.
Well, that came out in 99 for
Big
the
Willie
Millennium.
So all right, Wild Wild West then.
Oh.
Yeah, Wild Wild West, good.
Do you know he picked...
anything by Will Smith.
Do you know he was first in line to be Neo in The Matrix, and he went, oh, that's going to flop. I'll
go make Bright and Wild Wild West.
That's exactly what happened.
Oh, no.
Yeah, but he did all right, so it's fine.
Yeah, true, yeah, I'm not going to put porn out for him.
No.
Works in boots now. Seen that advert he's done where he works in boots?
Will Smith?
Yeah, he's put a boots uniform on and he's trying to sell this water to people. And they're like, are you Will Smith? And he's like, yeah, do you want to buy some water?
Yes.
Yes,
I do.
Yeah.
Sing Summertime. I'm a big fan of... There's a lot of those stories of actors that either turned down or were going to be cast or couldn't be cast in roles where obviously you're like, The Matrix is... What's his name? Keanu Reeves or whatever. You're like, oh, just be mad to have Will Smith.
And also imagine reading the script for The Matrix and go, no.
Yeah, right. Like, no. Just go, no.
No, that's shit.
He probably just didn't get it.
Yeah, that's what it was.
It's always too complicated for me.
Yeah, that's not going to sell.
Yeah. Missed a trick there.
Yeah, well, they actually did he though? Because the first one was good. The other two were shit.
Well, yeah, but massive franchise, yeah. I mean, financially, and also just cult following alone. Do you know what I mean? Just cinema-wise is unique, so.
Mm. Let's end on that. Here it is, a cool slight. The common clay,
sometimes I'm saying something and I'm like, what am I saying? You can't stop halfway through. Like, if we were just chatting, I'd just go, oh,